This afternoon, as we welcome the President of Ireland and Dr. McAleese, officials from within the GAA, delegates from across Ireland and beyond, and all of you who have joined us for this special event here, we do so in a day where we will begin the hosting of the GAA Congress here in Down for the first time in 30 years. In our extensive preparations over these past few months, we have endeavoured to uphold our reputation as a good host, to also provide a memorable weekend for those who will come to Newcastle over these coming days, with the hope that there will be pleasant weather that we were eventually blessed with, and also to extend a warm Cead Míle Fáilte to all who have visited us over these few days. All counties who have achieved success on or off the field have a desire to celebrate certain milestones of that achievement along the way. And that is no less true in County Down. In the planning stages, our ambitious plans for this event, we were very conscious that in the Golden Jubilee anniversary year of 1960, we could not let the opportunity pass without acknowledging a significant achievement of our own. This event has been billed very appropriately as an iconic event, in that it allows us the opportunity to celebrate and to honour the players and the mentors, the team of 1960 and 61. And we wanted to do it with as many people as we could possibly do it with, on a grand scale, and also to reflect the magnitude of the achievement back in 1960, as well as the regard we have had for these players. That victory was not simply developed just for the GAA and Down. It was a groundbreaking success that had an impact within and beyond the county and within and beyond the association. These were men who became, in that time, household names across the land and provided an inspiration for teams within and beyond County Down and Ulster and further afield, but also for the generations of players who followed in their footsteps in the red and black.
Erthur on the hern, Erthur on the hern, Taskiel, Ian is special to Irish Academy there. Bohai Clum, Mark, you heard that, Christy Clendy on down, Falcha Mora Corru, Gach Enna, and you, Mara Sachet, Sterl, Eshach. Our president has had a long, close connection and affinity with us here in town, onto the GAA in this part of the world. She's blessed us on many occasions with her presence, and during her term as Uachtaráin. And as we prepare to host our first Congress in 30 years, we're delighted that she's again with us, and you're most welcome, and we recognize you. Counties throughout Ireland have been blessed with some success at one level or another, and have taken time to mark their occasions and remember the events. And that's, perhaps that's more true here and Down with the impact of the All-Ireland victory in 1860. A first for Down and a day that changed the GAA in the landscape of the Mourns here. Countless followers of the Red and Black have enjoyed the memories of those early 60s brought up knowing about the significance of the achievements 50 years ago. Those who have worn the county colour since have known that they are followed in the footsteps of history makers. When we were offered the opportunity to host Congress here, we had a determination to leave an impression on those who visit us and to highlight the presence of this conference here in Down to the world around us. While we offer a warm welcome to our members of the 60 and 61 team and their families, we also remember in a poignant way those who have passed to their eternal rest over recent years. We hope that today's event is a fitting way to recall and to mark that unique success. Romila Mychag of Gillard.
In the coming weeks, we look forward to the National League finals, as well as the growing anticipation towards our championships. But Congress within the GAA is an important event within its calendar. And over these coming days, delegates from across Ireland will be making decisions on key rules and constitutional matters within the association. It is a very busy time for our leading officials. Last year, a courtman was inaugurated as the most recent president. We are delighted to have him here in Down this weekend. Ladies and gentlemen, Uachtaráin Cumannuachas Gael, Christy Cooley.
As everyone aware, this weekend is an important one for the GAA. As delegates gathered here among the Mourns in beautiful Newcastle County Down for our association's annual Congress. To say that the setting is magnificent would be something of an understatement. And I think I speak for many when I say I relish the chance to come to this beautiful part of Ireland when the opportunity presents itself, which is not often enough as far as I'm concerned. Congress begins together. GAA members and delegates from all strands of the association, and provides them with the chance to discuss and catch up on Council's initiatives and projects that are unique in our different units and the communities that host them. However, what they have all in common is the fact that they are working towards the same goal, the promotion of our games and culture on a voluntary basis in a spirit that is underpinned by our all-important amateur ethos. Congress is the ultimate decision-making body of the association and takes place but once a year. This year it returns to Down for the first time since 1980, and much has happened in that period, including the recording of two All-Ireland senior football wins for Down, in addition to a number of other noteworthy achievements at a variety of different grades. Yesterday morning before going to Stormont, I visited four different schools in the area, and it is obvious for me from these visits they are not alone at Gaelic Games, alive and well in this part of Ireland. They are thriving. The pupils, the teachers, and the principal schools I all visited displayed a passionate draw for our games, and activities that draw well for Down and for the GAA as a whole. and I would like to thank Mrs. Quinn of St. Delian's Warren Point, Mrs. Cunningham of St. Malachy's Castle Wellen, Mr. McParland of the Sacred Heart Dundrum, and Mrs. McMullen of St. Joseph's Ballinkittle for hosting our events. To see both the school and club colours being paraded with such pride was hugely encouraging. And I'm sure that James McCartan and his team of City County footballers can expect great support in their forthcoming league final against Armagh and indeed for the remainder of this year. Of course, the delegates gathered here from the four corners of Ireland and further afield are not the only ones present this weekend who make a special contribution to the affairs and activities of our association. In fact, I think that most of them would agree that it's our players and their actions on the field of play that helps underpin the special passion that makes our association what it is today. To that end, I could not think of a more fitting way to mark the Congress this weekend than by hosting the All-Ireland winning team in 1661 at this impressive event today. To say that this embodies the spirit that epitomises the GAA and our association down in particular would be stating the obvious. I had the privilege of meeting these panel of players at Croke Park recently when the stadium hosted them as part of an event to honour their efforts and achievement, of which was undoubtedly a groundbreaking era, not alone for Down football, but a golden era for the game itself in general. I encountered firsthand the warmth and the special bond, still very much in evidence, may I add, that made this group winners and pioneers at the same time. And I caught a glimpse at close quarters of the characters that this team, that makes them tick. Their exploits were recorded on the football field, but their influence flowed far beyond the white lines, helping to eliminate so many lives in different ways. Those followers of football from that era who have testified to their successes captured the imaginations of legions of football followers. And it's amazing that I still hear today of the idols that the Down team of that period were to so many people, and far beyond the confines of County Down. The panache, the style, and the verve brought to Croke Park for the final of 1960 announced the arrival of this team as a force to be reckoned with.
We began to truly appreciate the significance of the event we were planning over these past few months when we realised that we would be joined by the Uachtaráin na hÉireann and blessed with their presence as we are this afternoon. In particular, we truly appreciate the effort she has made taking account of her very busy schedule.
Virginia and Kelura lay spashelta, a blean shaska, EJ Xashaska, Agus, Egoscoch, Co Gile, Common Blue Class Gale, Yavila Subjay. It's an absolute joy and honour to be here on this really very special golden anniversary of a great day, a great 2 years. Wonderful and remarkable time, and to be here for the opening in the wonderful Newcastle on a gorgeous sunny day when the streams of sunshine are blessing this company, to be here for the opening of Cogyle Common Low Class Gale 2010. I'm very, very grateful to Fergal McCormick for the invitation to be among each and every one of you, particularly among the members and families of that legendary and history-changing team, their mentors and their management. This outfit is not just the outfit that I'm wearing specially for today because of the day that's in it. It's also the outfit that I always wear when I go to Valentia Island. along with GAA personnel and delegates from across Ireland and beyond, civic and religious leaders, present and past officers of Cúisne Chontae an Dún, and the friends of the GAA. Congress, I know, will be and is planning for the future. But before the plans are set in concrete, before the future is set out in front of us, we're going to do what the Chinese proverb tells us we should do. We who drink the water are going to acknowledge with gratitude those who dug the well. And what a well they dug between them. Those down all Ireland winning heroes of 1960 and 1961. They did not just win mighty games of football, though they did that. They didn't just bring a unique freshness and style and good looks to Gaelic football. They lifted an entire nation. They inspired a people. And above all, the Kingdom of Mourne beat the Kingdom of Kerry. Life is strange, you know. We reared our children to be what they are, really solid, unbreakable, implacable Down supporters. But my eldest daughter is now, of course, the daughter-in-law of a gentleman called Mick O'Connell. You might remember him. But anyway, you can imagine the additional mileage and regular mileage I get out of a certain day in 1916 when we're in the company of the in-laws, and you can be sure I take full advantage of it. Actually, it was Mick O'Connell who very recently confirmed to me the prophetic genius and the rapid wit of Paddy Doherty when he recently recounted a conversation between himself and Paddy close to full time in Croke Park on that September day in 1960. Paddy had just kicked that famous winning penalty, and he was strolling back to his place beside Mick O'Connell. And as he passed Mick, Mick said to him, "How much time's left?" And Paddy said to him, 364 days. Sometimes confounds the player just how long as the players just how long a shelf life those memories have. The names of the players, the names of the management team, that name Maurice Hayes, those names, the names of Carr, the names of Musson, the names of Duffy, you know all the names. It would be a sin to list them all because in listing them they've been already listed here two or three times. Those names so well known, just the saying of them in a conversation around any lunch table or dinner table, it evokes not actually just static memories or pictures, but such a rush, such an adrenaline rush of pride, a rallying of effort, and a push to victory. It doesn't matter in what discipline, what code, whether it's an exam, just thinking of those names, the push to pride, the push to victory, not alone in the Gaelic football field, but in so, so many areas of life. Down's loyal supporters, we know, they smashed every single attendance record in the book. And the respect garnered by those teams we honour today was evident in the crowds that turned up at every crossroads town, every village, as Sam Maguire travelled for the first time north across the border to County Down. I was 9 years old when that first happened. Do not do the maths. And, nothing, absolutely nothing in my life until then had opened up to me the concept of the realm of possibility and such faith in the future. I still have faith that before my time in Aris Nochtheron is over, another Down team will lift the Sam Maguire, and they did. And if they do, and when they do, they will owe their pedigree, their ambition, and the gold standard they seek to emulate to those in whose name we gather today, those whom we honour today. They, as I said, they need no naming, but I suppose in a very special way we think of some of the men who lined out on those famous days and who are not with us today, Breen Morgan, Pat Rice, Patsy O'Hagan, Jonathan Kerry, to name just the players. It really is miraculous what just one penalty kick can do for the annals of history.
We have been driven onwards in our plans over the last few weeks and months under the stewardship of our chairman of the host committee, Fergal McCormick. And I will now ask Fergal to make a special presentation to you for your kind acceptance of our invitation today.
President McAleese, thank you for your inspirational address and for honouring us. Gaelic Pottery have commissioned a one-off unique basket, which they say never, never has been done before. And it says, presented to Mary McAleese, Uachtarán na hÉireann, to mark the 50th anniversary celebrations of the Down 1960 and 61 historic teams.
If I could now ask the members of the 1960 and 61 team, the mentors and the representatives of those deceased, to make their way with the President of Ireland to our garden down on your left corner for special photographs. And if we could also ask everyone else to remain with us, and those who are seated to remain seated, we enjoy your food and your and company, and we will be back to you with our proceedings in a few minutes.
In the Banbridge Down, in the County Down, one morning last July, down a born and green came a sweet Colleen, and she smiled as she passed me by. She looked so sweet from her shimmering feet to the sheen of her nut brown hair. Such a coaxing of your eye to shake myself to make sure she was really there. From Antibet to Derry Cave, from Galway to Dublin Town, no maid had seen but the fine Colleen that I met in the County Down. As she onward sped, I scratched me head, and I said with a feeling rare, and I said aye to the passerby, who is the maid with the nut brown hair. He smiled at me, and with pride says he, that's the gem of Ireland's crown. We rode the McCann from the banks of the Banshee, the star of the County Down. From Banshee Bay to Derry Cay, and from Galway to Dublin Town, who made it seem with the fine Colleen that I met in the County Down. Harvest fair, she was surely there, and I dressed in my Sunday clothes. Each sheep's eyes to the litter and lies for the sake of the nut brown rose. No horse I yoked, a pipe I smoked until it's a rust coloured brown. To the smiling bride by my own far side, sits the star of the County Down. From Antibet to Derry Cay, and from Galway to Dublin Town, who made it seem that the fine Colleen that I met in the county down. From Banshee Bay to Dunley Kay and from Galway to Dublin town, who made it seem that the fine Colleen that I met in the county down.